It is a sticky brown. It's my nemesis. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today I am going to try this one, which is from You Can Be. It's called the Magic Spell Eyeshadow Palette. It has been kind of floating around online and yeah, I thought it looked really, really pretty, so I ordered it. I've had it in my home for a few weeks and I have just gotten around to playing with it. So there's that. I ordered mine off AliExpress because I usually do. I will leave it down below. But yeah, before we go any further, let me kinda, because we're in December, grab my Miss Muffet headband. I can kinda interchange her between, I can also, this is also a headband. So I can use this one as well. So yeah, but you guys really seem to like Miss Muffet. So now she has a Santa hat. But yeah, without further ado, this came in a sleeve and the ingredients are on the back. The ingredients are also on the back of the sleeve. So you don't have to save it if you don't want to. It feels nice. It's cardboard. It feels nice. It feels, I don't know, soft. It comes with a slip. It does look really pretty though. Oh, I actually have two slips. I have a slip on the eyeshadow. And I also, you cannot see probably, but I also have a protector on the mirror. So there's that. But yeah, this is, I can fold it back. This is what she looks like. When I got it home, I was like, I don't know how much I will like the color story. But yeah, I did see some people play with it. I saw that Laura did her, I think, a first impression and three looks. I will link it down below. But yeah, I thought, now I want to play with it as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to swatch it first. And then we shall see after that. So yeah, I do think that the color story is nice and soft. So if you're not a very colorful eyeshadow lover like me, but still want to have a little bit of color, I don't think this one, it has a bad color story for that. But yeah, it's maybe a little bit too soft for me. But doesn't mean it cannot be pretty, does it? So I'm going to swatch. I'm going to swatch on a clean bare arm. Let me get a makeup wipe. I don't use primers when I swatch, just so you know. So there's that. Okay. Here's the color story. Some of the mattes swatch a bit badly. And by badly, I mean thin. So you saw me build up some of the shades. That is just, they feel soft and creamy. But I kind of do need to dig my finger in to get a little bit of payoff on my finger. But then again, the finger is not the same as a brush. Same with some of the shimmers. Some of the shimmers I really needed to dig my finger in. But still, I think, yeah, when I look at it like this, it kind of surprises me a bit. So there's that. So now I need to kind of think, okay, so I have cleaned my arm and I was debating on doing a kind of a palette bingo style, but actually I want to use as many of the mattes as I can. So I have here, what is it? The Morphe M507. I'm going to start with the color Evil, which is the darkest one. I'm going to start with tapping it on my outer V. This is a nice shade, guys. It's nice and pigmented. It is not, they do feel creamy when swatching, but they're almost a little bit harder pressed in the pan. They're not, they are pigmented, but not overly so. And I can see that I can build this one up, which is good. It just makes it more accessible and workable for a lot of people, you know? Did I say we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mattes and the rest are shimmers? So my eyeshadow base is still a bit tacky, but not overly so. This one has, I have a little problem blending this one out though, because it really wants to stick, which is good, but it's also a little bit more difficult to work with then. It does not really matter though, but still, just so you know. Okay, next I am going to go into the color Phantasmal, which is that pinky. And it's going to go on the inner part. Same brush, because why not? I cleaned it in between on my towel. Yeah, so this one is a little bit easier to blend earlier. It places nicely. It's not overly in your face pigmented, but it's buildable, so that's good. Let's see if I can make the color Bewitchment show up a little. Let's use that to blend out the darker brown here. Yeah, it is too close to my skin tone. Which is not really a problem, because then you can nicely use it as an extra blending shade. If you just want to blend the edges nicely, but don't want the color up too high. Okay. I want to use the color Invisible as well. Can you tell? I'm going to use all the mattes, just so you know. Let's see how it layers. Now I'm working on a set base. It's showing up. So that's good. I really wasn't expecting it. Okay, let's go and build everything up. So I'm going to start with the color Evil, the darker brown. Then I'm going to go to the color Phantasmal, which was the pink again, to build everything up. Yeah, okay. So I have here a very soft blending brush that works a little bit better. With nicely blending it out. So there's that. So I think this is dark enough for a lot of people. I wish I could get it a little bit darker, but then again, it is almost close to pan, so yeah. Now I'm going to go to the pinky color, which was called Phantasmal again. Okay. Cleaning the brush, going back into the color Bewitchment, which was that lightest brown. To make sure that everything is nice and blended here at the front. Okay, next in the color Invisible again, which was that other brown. And I'm going to bring that one around as well. I'm going to switch brushes and go back into the color Bewitchment, which is that lightest brown, just to make sure that this part is nice and blended. Okay, we have one matte color left, which is the green that I'm going to grab now, which is called ESP. Okay, I want a bit more darkness in the crease. Yes, I do. So I'm going to go into the color Evil, which was the darkest brown. It is a sticky brown. It's my nemesis. Even though I'm putting it on a set base because I have eyeshadow, I can feel it sticking. And I had the same issue with one of the mattes in the green ColourPop palette. Okay, a little bit more of the pink. It needs to be something along those lines. Okay. Okay, so let me grab the color Dimension, which is this one. Which is very pretty. It's a brown with a green shift. I'm going to spray it because I'm going to place it underneath my eye first. Very pretty. I really like colors like this, actually. And the nice thing about this one is that, yes, it has a brown base, but the brown base is not very prominent. I'm going to clean my brush. Next, I'm going to go into the color Sorcery. I'm going to spray that as well. Next, I'm going to go into the color called... the color Dispel, this one. Ooh, I pick up a lot actually, so it's probably fallouty. I haven't sprayed it, I want to see what it does dry. So this is the darkest shimmer in the palette. Yeah, I'm going to spray. Let's get the color called Cure, which is this one. Oh, this is a little bit more moussey, so let me try it first. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, I'm going to spray. My brush doesn't want to pick up a lot. Could be the brush. That's better. Okay. Let's go into the color with a different brush, a small brush. Let's go into the color called Black Magic. And I think I can use this one as a topper as well. But it's the same kind of formula as the color Cure that I just used. Oh, very flaky, very fallouty. So let me spray. I have sprayed it and I still have massive, massive fallout. Wow. Let me see if I can get rid of the fallout. Oh no. I have a glittery eye. Let's see what happens when I use it with my finger. It's... I don't know, it looks almost like more of a topper. It's very pretty, but I don't like to use shimmers with my fingers because I cannot be precise. It has a lot of glitter flecks in it. But if you blend it out, you kind of sheer it out, but it's very pretty that way. Okay. Inner corner, let's use the white because I can. And the white is called Wizardry. Okay, let's spray. So I'm going to go back into the color Evil, which is that dark brown matte. Okay. That's the eye look so far. So I'm going to finish it off with liner, lashes and mascara and the lippy. I will be right back to show you the finished look and give you some thoughts I have on this palette. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. So my battery ran out on me, so I hope I'm still in the same spot. But anyway, everything is on and here is the finished look. I do like how it turned out. So there's that. You saw me. The shimmers with a spray and not a glitter primer. The eye you did not see me do. I used a glitter primer underneath and that works so much better. It is insane. So if you have this palette, use a glitter primer underneath your shimmers. It will change the game tremendously. I hope you can see the difference in shine. So this is the sprayed side. This is the one with the glitter primer. This one is way more intense. And has a lot less fallout. So there is that. Eye pencil is one from Hema. I don't know the color. I bought it because of this color. And it is... I swatched it here. It is a grayish purple. It's so pretty. Then I paired it with the ColourPop mascara in purple. And that's almost, when it dries, the same tone. So yeah. Falsies are my natural falsies from the Glamlash collection. And Lippy is from Revolution. It's one of their sheer glosses in the color Chauffeur, which is a bit pinky. And I thought it would complement the look nicely. So I just went on the You Can Be site to see what it retails for on their site. It retails for $14. Please don't be fooled. It says there that it is discounted from $22 to $14. Don't pay $22 for this palette. It is not a bad palette, but it is not worth $22. So yeah, I got it on AliExpress. Let me see if I can find out what I paid, because I don't remember. I forgot. So yeah, I just went on AliExpress. You can buy this palette for around €8, but you can also get a bundle. And I think I got that bundle actually with this palette and then this palette. And then you pay, say, I don't know, 15 or 16 euros for both palettes. So, yeah, basically around 8 or 9 euros. That is 10 to 12 bucks is a nice price to pay for this palette. Is it a bad palette? No, it is not a bad palette. The mattes are nice. They're a bit sheer, they're a bit thin, but you can build them up. The nice thing about that is, if you are not used to working with colors like this, it is not very scary, or it shouldn't be very scary, because you can really, really build them up. And it's not a dip in the brush in, put on your face, an instant explosion of color. So you don't have to be afraid of that. I do wish that there was a black in here. I think that would have complemented the palette very nicely. You only have 5 mattes, the rest are shimmers. So, yeah. You know, and for me personally, the dark brown just isn't dark enough to really darken up the look. But that is me. So these two are pretty sticky and can give you a little bit of a hard time if you want to work with them. You can work with them, you can blend them out, but you need a little bit more time to do that. And maybe a softer brush instead of a scratchier brush, you know, different types of brushes. I have both. Softer brush is nicer to blend these two out with. So there's that. I did not have any issue with this one or this one, or even with this one, even though you don't really see it on my skin tone. Still, it worked very, very nicely. You have a few shimmer formulas in here. You can probably see it here and see it here. These are very, very flaky. This one and this one is the same formula. Very flaky, very glittery and kind of a little bit loose. You can use them nicely as a topper, but if you do that, be prepared to receive massive fallout. So use your eyes first, because you can use them really, really sheer. Here I only sprayed it and it was very sheer. I could nicely blend it out and then blend it like, use it like a topper shade. Here I use it on top of a glitter primer. The glitter primer I use is from NYX, and once you put shadow there, it ain't going anywhere, so you cannot really blend it out then. So there is that. However, if you use it here on a glitter primer, it is way more intense and opaque, so it is a formula that you can play with, which is nice if you like that. If you want to get payout of the shimmers regardless, spray your brush or use your finger. But yeah, in my experience, it's best on the glitter prime. But if you don't have that, you know. This one is pretty glittery, as is this one. So the normal shimmers are glittery. Very tiny, but glittery nonetheless, especially the light ones. So these two, this one is very nice. I love this shimmer, actually. I think it's actually the prettiest shimmer in the palette. But yeah, different formulas, but still, put them on top of a glitter glue. They are very, very nice that way. I think that is it. I don't really know what to say about it. Is it my worst palette? No. Is it my best palette? No. It's okay. It's an okay palette. If you like the color story and you want to have an alternative that, or something that is not too expensive but still nice quality, go and grab it. That's basically it, I think, guys. So yeah, I think that's it. Don't forget to check out Laura's videos on this palette. I will leave them down in the description box. And yeah, guys, that was it. That was it for my first impression of the You Can Be Magic Spell eyeshadow on palette. So yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.